a very complex system that can be naturally found in video. If we fractionate it by according to the solubility, we can obtain the two fractions, which are the glycine and glutenin. Both two fractions are a very important contributor to the rheological properties of dough. Glycine is single-chain polypeptide which contributes to the viscous pore of components, and glutenin is multiple chain which contribute to elastic polymer network. And elastic polymer can be explained by when we stretch the gluten and release the force, it will snap back to its original shape. Rheological testing or physical testing is the study of the flow or the deformation of the material, such as creep recovery test, which can be performed by using rheometer. This test is to apply the small deformation to the gluten by using a shear constant stress. And the other test is compression test by using this machine called gluten compression recovery analyzer. This test is to apply large deformation test, and by using the compressed force for a constant time and release force in a constant time. These two instruments is very useful because it can separate the viscosity and elasticity of the gluten. But this instrument, it has a very high cost, and also it takes a longer time to do the test. But this test, it has lower cost, and it takes a shorter time to do the test. The objective of my study is to determine the effect of substituting commercial gluten on rheological properties of gluten. I selected one commercial-based flour and then substituted it with five different commercial gluten products, and then added it with four different levels of each gluten product. Each product also tested with the pH by using an official AACC method. Gluten extraction was performed by washing the soluble part of dough, and then the gluten obtained will be tested by creep recovery test and compression test. Statistical analysis was performed by analysis of variance and pair comparison by t-test. The effect of protein content on the percent recoverability for each gluten product. There is no significant difference in the percent recoverability when we tested with the creep recovery test. This is the result of the viscosity of the gluten. It showed that these two products had an effect on the viscosity of the gluten when we increase the protein content. It can be explained by its acidity and also the molecular size, because this product has a high acidity and this product has a low molecular weight. This represents the deformability of gluten. And again, these two products affect the gluten by will make the gluten more deformable. This is an example graph of actual testing from compression recovery test. The percent recoverability is obtained by these three factors: the initial thickness of the gluten, the ending thickness when it compacts, and then the final thickness when it releases the recover. And then the recover already was calculated. This is the result of the percent recoverability as a function of protein content from compaction recovery test. The take-home message of this graph is, number one, these two products, again, it make the percent recoverability of gluten decrease, and these three products, it make the percent recoverability of gluten decrease. And the other one take-home message is that this compaction recovery test can discriminate the percent recoverability when we add more protein content with many gluten products. In comparison of pre-recovery test and compaction recovery, it can be easily tell that this large deformation can discriminate better than the small deformation. In conclusion, small molecular weight and higher acidity negatively affect percent recoverability. Significant changes in percent recoverability starting at 4% substitution and large deformation can discriminate percent recoverability better than small deformation. Thank you.